truck by Pete and Haskell there once. It's 10 o'clock, I'll call this meeting order. Roll call.
Martin Ferry.
Here.
Sandy Zachary.
Here.
Billy Cloud.
Here. Item number three, please, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Item number four is recognized guest. I want to thank everybody for being here. I think the sheet's going around now, or it's already went around. Item number five, new business. Sandra, you got a new business today?
Yes, they got the elevator fixed last Wednesday. He gave me a call when he got it done. So I made a lot of people on the second floor happy, I know. But it was out a week, so it got it done. Also, Chris Bowler, the OEM, they got the courthouse and the hospital leaves right last week. We appreciate that. Took care of some other business and got that taken care of. District 2 helped on, so I think we're pretty well caught up right now. The supplies on the hospital, on the office, and the lobby came in last Wednesday. I was driving around and stopped and talked to the gentleman. Also, Andrea did resubmit that to the bankruptcy trustee. He did send the money on that and also on the roof. So that won't be taken out of the city or the county on that. So she got on that real fast. The supplies for the roof, as far as I know, have not come in yet.
What's the total on both those items?
You're going to have to ask. Now I've got it in here. It was around $4,500, I believe, is what that was total all of it.
But he did approve it?
Yes, and she got the money and took care of it.
That's a surprise. I wonder what he's thinking.
And once she got it, she just went forward with it and got it taken care of. The schedules for the meeting for 2020 holidays, they will, I've got them looked at. I want to have the commissioners look at them later. And then we will sign it on the 30th when the excise board has their meeting.
I'd like to thank we've been fighting this battle with paying this money on this retirement, you know, that they carry over the penalties and interest. A lot of times when a person works temporary on the job so long and it's hopeful they start paying it, holding out a check, and the county don't pay it in, well then if they get on permanently, then they charge a penalty and excise tax. Some of that goes back to 99, 98, stuff like that. It's been run up since I've been here. They bill the county for about $58,000 on these retirements. It doesn't affect the retiree. It don't make this check any better, any lower, anything. But, and so I got in and called them, and when I got to discussing it with them, they don't even give me the recipe of how they come up with some money, you know, like they charge the city the same as they did the county at $18,000-something that time. And he just worked there a year and worked all this over here, you know, all the time over here, and they charge the same amount, you know, I mean. And then I ask them, where does the money go? These penalties and excise tax, they don't know, they wouldn't tell me, you know.
Penalties and interest.
Yeah, penalties and interest, where's it go, you know? Who gets it? And they said, well, they didn't, nobody really know. So
they also didn't know how to assess the penalties.
Yeah, and that's what I was talking about, you know, when they had the recipe on it, you know, to assess that, how they come up with these figures. Anyway, I called Larry Balls and Randy Rand, and they're working with them, and they're going to try to get it into legislation to have that changed. I called Gene Wallace, and Gene, you know, I sent him everyone that's retired since I've been here. We kept it in the folder and everything, and I sent that up to him to look at today. And he told me, you know, that they've been doing it for 60 years. That he called it a contract, but it's really not a contract. I think it's a state, you know. But anyway, I told him, I said, well, then maybe we can get in and renegotiate the contract, you know. And then he said, well, it's really not a contract. And then he said, on down in another county, it was a $92,000 bill they sent for somebody to retire, you know. And I told told him, I said, well, what if we get where we can't pay things, what do we do then? And he said, well, he told me I was trying to change something. I said, I'm not trying to change anything. I said, I just, we'll pay what we should have paid, you know what I mean? But we don't want to pay the penalties and the interest. And he said, well, send me the paperwork, let him look at it, you know, see. And then Randy and them, they're all bored to go ahead and try to, if it's a contract or what, or negotiate something new, you know, so we can afford it. We can't afford it, I think, you know. When we have problems with money anyway, if we can't buy equipment or nothing else, or hardly pay the leases on them, and then we've got to come up with this kind of money, well, I think we ought to do something. And if you counted it, 77 counties just going on, there's hundreds of thousands of dollars going somewhere, and ain't nobody can tell you where they go, where it goes. So I think they ought to, if they're gonna send us a bill, they ought to break it down and tell us exactly how they done it, how they come up with this figure, and they ought to also tell you where that money's going.
The way the tax commission IRS is, if you owe, they send you bills, and so much penalty and interest, and it goes on daily, and you put on notice that you owe it. In this case, you don't even know you owe it.
You don't know.
They just charge you penalty and interest for years and years and years, and you have no idea you're getting charged.
Getting charged, and plus, it's not doing the retiree any good, and it's breaking the county, so why would you?
Somebody's collecting all the penalty and interest and
doing something
else with it.
Yeah, and us in these little counties like this, so why are we doing it?
And the one case where there was an $18,000 fee, they sent it to the city,
yes,
and they also sent it to the county.
Yeah.
And then pulled one of them back.
Same identical charge.
And
yeah.
Same charge.
And if I hadn't been talking to Cheryl about something else and just kind of brought it up,
there would have been
we wouldn't have known about it.
Probably happened statewide.
Yeah. Well, so it does help to check it out.
It's a lot of, you know, there's a lot of answers. They did not give us any answers on. So I'm fighting with them, and so if you hear something, that's what it's about. But it's not affecting anybody's retirement. But they won't let you retire until it's paid. You know, I mean, they won't start the end. You got to pay it. So that's your repair with it and that. And if nothing else, I think we'll just quit paying it and let the judge thrash it out. Take it to the court. Let him say, you know, where we have to pay the penalties and the interest.
I think they ought to put you on notice how much you owe,
yeah,
and you get the right to pay it before they start charging you penalty and interest.
Yes, they ought to have said, you know, that he's been working here, and if you don't pay this, then your interest and penalties going to start building up. Mm-hmm. They don't send any kind of notice. They said, I asked them about it, why didn't they send a notice? They said, well, we just don't, we can't keep, we don't keep up with it that close, you know, we kind of blow it off, you know. But they don't check on it until you get ready to retire, so that's not a very good answer. Anyway, maybe we'll win it. Help us on the money. It's
definitely hurt us in the past.
Forget this. I did have one more thing. On the difference for the jail payment this month was $1,694.30. So I know I mentioned that in the jail meeting. So.
Considerably better than last month.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, $8,787.48, so that's a big difference.
Is that excess revenue? Or
no.
Or is it?
It's a minus.
Minus?
Yes.
Okay.
You have any new business, Sean? Sheriff?
Just got a couple things. The other night, two deputies are sitting, full-time deputy reserve sitting at Tomahawk Road and Cash Road there at the intersection. And a vehicle comes through the stop sign there. Actually, Garland. Come through the stop sign there at Garland. Get behind them, stop them. A stolen vehicle out of Texas. Got drugs, three individuals in it from the Kyoto area. Stolen vehicle, they stole out of Texas, brought it back. Two nights ago, get a call about a vehicle pulling in different driveways. Deputies make contact with it, wind up getting a substantial amount of meth out of that vehicle. And then the next night, deputies wind up getting another call about a guy pulling into some other driveways, appeared to be lost. They make contact with a rental car out of New York. It was rented out of Beaumont, Texas. Two two individuals in it. They were went up seizing a bunch of cell phones, credit card readers, credit cards. They had been started in Beaumont, Texas, and was working their way to New York, and they were stealing credit card identities, and they were stopping at Easy Marts, convenience stores, anything open, and using the credit card numbers they could use. They'd already been to Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, Kansas, came back here because their female compadre stayed in McAllister at the hotel, and she was hitting a bunch of stores in McAllister. We've got Secret Service supposed to contact us today, work, but looks like they've already been able to steal thousands and thousands of dollars and wind up catching them right on 31 Highway in Kenna. So, I mean, people don't realize it, but Kenna's not Kenta. 31 Highway is a thoroughfare. It's coming across. I mean, they're starting to work these little two-lane roads for drug trafficking, human trafficking, credit card trafficking. I mean, a bunch of different things like that is starting to come down these two-lane roads because the highway patrol's working the big roads. So, just kind of a coincidence. They got lost in Kenna and wound up pulling the Easy Mart when the deputies found them. So, hopefully we stop them from hitting our stores, but they were hitting stores all around us. Jail's operating smoothly. Didn't mention it last month at the meeting, or last week at the meeting. I wanted to wait till our jail board meeting to mention it. But the jail wound up having an unexpected inspection by the state, and there were zero deficiencies found during that. It's the third year in a row. Only about 7% of the jails across the state don't have any deficiencies, meaning zero write-ups. So that's a big thing that we're excited and we're happy about, because in the past there had been pages and pages of write-ups. So everything's going smoothly. We're guys are working hard, working daily. So we appreciate the commissioners. And commissioners came the other night, Friday night. The sheriff's office had we started what they call the Haskell County Law Enforcement Dinner, Christmas dinner. And we invite every law enforcement service that works in Haskell County. We had about 135 people show up, had over $3,000, almost $4,000 in door prizes, good meal, good time, and we appreciate Shauna and commissioners for showing up, because it just shows what the law enforcement, how they get along and how they go. We did have a special guest speaker. Her name was Karen. She came with commissioner, and Karen spoke, so it was a good time. But no, we had a good time. We appreciate everybody coming, and hopefully we're able to continue that and keep it going. So,
good meal for sure. Well,
appreciate it. We had two parades. We had a good turnout. Did two parades this week. Got McCurtain Parade next week. So hopefully, Billy Don, I haven't heard. I don't think Kenneth's having a parade, are they? I mean, they had one a couple years, and they haven't had one the last couple. So McCurtain's next week, next Saturday. And I think we'll have all the parades taken care of by then. So.
All right, we'll move on to item six. Approve commissioner's proceeding from previous meeting.
I make a motion on number six.
Sandra Zachary.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Bart McCleary.
Yes. Item number seven is approved blanket PO. We have any blankets? No. No blanket POs this week. Item number eight was reviewed, discussed, and approved 324-hour claims for right-of-ways on in Possum Hollow Road, District 1. Do we have any this week? This week, I'm going to make a motion to approve these 324-A's.
I second it.
Bart McCleary.
Yes.
Sandra Zachary.
Yes.
Billy Cook.
Yes.
Thank you.
County month, November monthly reports for assessor, county clerk, court clerk, treasurer's office, and health clerk.
I'll make a motion, I'm on number nine.
I'll second it.
Sandra Zachary.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Carter Perry.
Yes. Item number ten is discuss and consider lease purchase for Mack Truck for District Three, and we, I believe, have phone quotes for interest from, we have one here from Webb State Bank, and their rate was 3.95. We have one here from Central National here in Stigler, their rate was 3.8. We have another one here from First National Bank of Stigler, 3.95, and one from Farmer State Bank here in Stigler of 2.85. Farmer State was by far the lowest. Billy Don makes a motion, we accept Farmer State Bank. Quote on interest, I'll second it.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Carter Perry.
Yes.
Sandra Zachary.
Yes.
Item number 11 is possible action to approve Kettle Reap closeout documents and affidavits on. You have the Kettle thing? Okay, this is just the closeout on District 2, not District 1 and 3 Reap Grant, right?
How much money we got back from that chip loan?
Yeah, the $38,000. Make a motion we approve.
I'll second.
Martin Ferry.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Sandra Zachary.
Yes.
Did y'all just say this for two, it's for District One and Two?
I said one and three.
One and three. When two's in there, we should, I thought.
I thought theirs had been done, there's all up in this one deal, okay, well, I messed up.
One, two, there's a three over there.
One.
Four, five, and six is.
Yeah, they're all, for all three. There's one signature on each, is that for each district commissioner signing their own, or do you?
I can't see it though. No.
Does he sign?
Okay, I sign all three of them.
Then, yeah, your signature's printed in with Davey, and then Karen will sign the bottom of this one, so.
Do these two go together?
Together.
Okay, item number 12, discuss consider purchasing schematic prints for elevator number 220-7784 for Haskell County, 300A elevator cost for $485 for the set. And this is something that we have to have, so.
He emailed me and he wanted to know if we got a PO yet, and I was telling him that they were taking care of the meeting. I'll fax him the papers back over to him and then get a PO, and then they will send them, so.
There's no original ones?
We cannot find any, there's bits and pieces, but in order, we need the prints when they come. If we ever get audited through it, we'll be fined probably more than $485, so we need to go ahead and get these purchased.
Do we have an area to store the mechanical aspects of the records?
They're going to email them to me. I'm gonna email it to Karen, because on her paperwork is the bigger sheets, and I can send everybody out an email on it, and that way we can be able to have it in our systems.
I know, like the manuals for the chiller compressor and stuff down there are just laying up in it, and it doesn't take very, you know, humid down there. There's probably not the.
We need, like, even these elevator prints, we need in a place to safe keep it.
Yes, yeah. Yeah, we need to designate. There has to be one down there in the bottom floor in the room.
Right.
And then we put one in Karen's office, and like I say, we'll have it on our emails and give it out.
for the boiler and the compressor and stuff, those probably ought to be taken out of that
room.
Because the humidity down there was put over and where they're stored their supplies or something, if we could come up with a cabinet or something to put those in.
Put them in.
If you put all, you know, if you put everything in there, then you know where to go to.
Right.
I make a motion to pay this.
I'll second.
Sanders Zachary.
Yes.
Clark McLeary.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
I think you've got to sign this right here. Sign your name by commissioner, but your title's here, don't you? They may want you to print it, write it and
lock it for your title.
Yeah.
That's not a printed title.
Item number 13, discuss consider paying invoice 217110 for Dorner, Sanders, Daniels, and Anderson for the amount of $2,860 for 2 cents.
Yeah, that was your copy there. This was sent the other day, and I thought you were sending it down, you keep yours. This was $2,860.02. The total amount is $73,089.72 is the total as of right now.
That's what the county's been out on legal expenses on their half to keep hospital.
Yes. I make a motion to pay this.
I'll second.
Sanders Zachary.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Clark McLeary.
Yeah. Item 14, discuss consider signing Haskell County ECR 1220, also known as Peavy Road, Choctaw Project for the Choctaw Nation. Report number 2.
Yes, we have to do these by reports on their billing. And this is part 2 here. The project, and each time that they do so much work, then they bill the Choctaws, which we have to run through the meeting, and then they'll send it, and then we'll have to issue it out. So I make a motion.
I'll second.
I'll second.
And I also need y'all to sign the bottom of this one. They didn't say it until this last time. My job is
Sanders Zachary.
Yes.
Clark McLeary.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Just one place.
Yes.
Item number 15 is sign appropriations, transfers, appropriations, check received, and POs. I'll make that motion.
I'll second.
Clark McLeary.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Sanders Zachary.
Yes.
I
queues.
Yeah, they have some of the top people that go in there a lot. The wrong and Charles hangs that right on the other side.
That's a foot behind.
Like he's trying
came to the option, the highlight, and both of them to be. We transferred out and transferred back in adjustment.
That something that all of us should be gonna have to do because of something to be back at 16 or 17, transfer District 3 made from bridge into the highway 2. They said it's not illegal to do that, but you've got to put the money back. So I had to meet with Faye about it Thursday evening, and I told her to just do it on my, all we had to do is transfer that amount of dollars back from T2A into bridge. So I just told her to do it on my account so it wouldn't run anybody short. It's just merely a moving from highway 2 to bridge. Just a correction that had been made. No, that's all right, but I didn't have a chance to tell them about it. Closed it in here, folks, you can't see out.
Do you want to fall going on? Oh, yeah, we were going to do that. That slipped my mind. You'll have to take care of it.
Yeah, you did get all the in touch where you.
I
we'll move on to item 16, executive session. Do we have any, we need a motion to go into executive session.
I'll make a motion.
I'll second.
Sandra Zach?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
Clark McCreary?
Yes. Okay, we need a motion then back into regular session.
I make a motion.
Sandra Zach?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
Clark McCreary?
Yes. Okay, we're, there'll be no action taken regarding executive session. It was discussion only today. We'll move on to item 17, and that's to adjourn the meeting.
I make a motion to adjourn.
I'll second.
I'll second.
Sandra Zach?
Yes.